So let's look back at our statement. We talked about the jump statement. So the last thing we have to talk about is the iteration statement. And there are a couple of equivalent types of loops in C, and they're equivalent in terms of their means of executing code. So they are similarly powerful, but each of them is convenient for some other cases, and that's why these constructs exist, and there's not just a single construct. Good, so an iteration statement can be a while loop, a do while loop, and a for loop. And like I said, depending on the particular condition that you in your program have, you may choose one loop over the other for pure convenience. So let's have a look back at our range algorithm example. So we said here the range algorithm was there to determine from a set of numbers the maximum and minimum number. Therefore, we initialized it, the maximum to zero and the minimum to a very high number. And now we basically walk through here all these numbers. So as long as there are numbers left, we got the next number and then we updated min and max. So this is in the strict sense, this is a loop, because as long as there are numbers left, you continue to process the next number. So a loop, what is a loop now in more detail? It's a sequence of statements that we repeat. There are two general types of loops. One is the way you keep trying and repeat a loop until you find a specific solution or until a specific condition is met. And in the other one, you know the number of iterations that you want to perform, like n many, and you repeat something this often. So the condition determines when to stop the looping. And in a for loop, we initialize and iterate over a condition. And in a while loop, we have a so-called sentinel that controls the repetition. That means as long as the sentinel condition is true, we repeat the operation. This allows you also to do indefinite repetitions. And the while loop is typically used when you don't know the number of repetitions a priori. And every time you have to check the sentinel condition and you stop looping if that one becomes ever false. In any case, there's also a means to stop the looping of such loops using the break statement, as we will see. So now let's dive into those types of loops. So let's start with the while loop. So it's a sentinel-controlled repetition loop. So the program keeps looping while a condition is true. So it looks in fact very similar to an if condition, just that we now say while the condition is true. Well, we run the code this is inside our block. So all the statements here are repeated until this condition is not met anymore. So note that the condition is also checked before the loop begins, which makes sense, right? As long as this condition is met, you run the statements. So you can look at the flowchart. The flowchart of the while loop looks like this. We evaluate the condition expression. If it's false, we go on with the code. If it's true, we execute all the statements inside the loop body. So we talk also about loop body, which are typically the statements inside this block. And you talk about loop condition, well, which is the condition by which you iterate or stop iterating. So here's an example now. We set a counter to 1 and we say as long as the counter is smaller or equal to 10, you print the counter and then we increment the counter by 1. So think a moment by yourself what this code does. Well, yes, it's very similar to what we have done with our go-to statement here, where we looped from 0 to 9. Now we want to loop from basically 1 to 10. Let me briefly copy the code for you and execute it. So this is now the while loop. So int counter equals 1 while counter is less than 10. As long as the counter is less than 10, right, we print the counter and then we set counter plus plus incrementing counter. Right, so I hope you have now thought through how often this code is executed. Well, it should be executed 10 times because we start with 1 and we stop when the counter is identical to 10. We have our last iteration. So with 11, then the counter gets incremented to 11. We go back to the while loop and the condition returns false. Let me show you. Okay, GCC while, so it prints the number 1 to 10, right? I think it's also a very good exercise again if you try to understand what's going on, for example, for a smaller number of iteration like 3, and you walk through the code, right? We start here, counter becomes 1, we perform the while loop, trying to check the condition, is counter less than 3? Yes, it is. So we print the counter, which prints at the moment 1. Then we increment counter, so counter becomes 2. Is counter less than 3? Yes. So we print it, counter becomes 3. Well, as long as counter is less or equal than 3, yes, it's true. So we print it, counter becomes 4. Well, the condition is evaluated to be false. So we go here on with the code here and say, you know, next statement after the loop, for example. So that's, I think, not a big deal. You should really understand how that works. And you see that it's exactly what happened in this case. So sometimes we use in a while loop this kind of sentinel as a kind of failure condition. So we say, for example, as long as our work result is all right, so we get a positive result, we do some work, and then we compute a new work result, and as long as this is all right again, we continue to work. That is quite similar, for example, to say, as long as, you know, there is a person in the room that I haven't handed out a worksheet, I hand over a worksheet. And then at some point you say, well, our result is that there is no such person anymore, so I cannot hand over a worksheet. So handing over a worksheet. Similarly, you could adjust this now, this kind of example that I've given you. What happens if I try to hand over a worksheet and a person says, please don't give me a worksheet? So our result would be not all right, it would be an error. In this case, I want to stop as well handing over worksheets and, I don't know, instruct the people, give them further advice and so on. So the while loop has a small variant, which is the do while loop. There is only one difference, that the while condition is always checked, in this case, at the end. So it's checked when you see the while loop, so the do while loop checks the condition at the end of the statements, so it will loop over the code at least once. So let me try that here. Save this example as while do while. And so we say do this while counter is less or equal than 3. Yeah. So does this make a difference in this example? No, it doesn't, for the reason that in this case, we will loop over this code always more than once. But if I would set the counter, for example, to 10, then you would find that I would print 10, I increment it to 11, and then I perform the check in our while condition to see that this condition is not met, and I would exit my code. So let's try it. Do while I will print 10, I would exit the loop. Let me revert the example case back Okay, 1, 2, 3. Next statement after the loop, so that works. And if you would have the while loop, like I said, the condition is checked always where the while keyword is written. So it would be written before the loop. So I will check it before. So if I set the number to 10, this statement gets evaluated to false. So in that sense, the code is never being executed. You see, it's not executed. Okay, so let me go back with the code and let's proceed. So here is the do while loop flowchart. So we execute the statements and then we evaluate the condition expression. And well, if it's true, we execute the statements again. So you see the slight variation from this little flowchart here.